We are going to discuss certain remarks concerning the previous theorems. We have already done the theorem, the integral over L p dx plus q dy depends only on the endpoints if and only if the integrand is exact differential. Because p is equal to del u del x, q is equal to del u del y, and we have del p del y equal to del del y del u del x, that will be equal to del square u del y del x. Suppose number one, del v del x, sorry, del q del x, this will del del x of del u del y, that is equal to del square u del x del y. Number two, but these two partial derivatives, second order partial derivatives, are equal. Del square u del y del x is equal to del square u del x del y, as u x y is continuous. Hence we have del p del y equal to del q del x by 1 and 2, which is the condition of exactness of the differential p dx plus q dy. So we can say that integral over L p dx plus q dy depends only on endpoints if and only if the integrand is an exact differential. Remark number two, the condition of exactness of fz dz equal to fz dx plus I times fz dy. Now you want to find the condition of exactness of this differential. By definition of exact differential, there must exist a function capital FZ in D such that del F del X equal to FZ and del F del Y equal to I FZ, because if you express it in the form P dx plus Q dy, then P will be FZ and Q will be I FZ, where P is equal to del U del X, Q is del U del Y, that is partial derivatives of u with respect to x and y. Here in place of u we have capital F, so capital del F del X will be equal to FZ and del F del Y will be equal to I FZ. This is our del F del X, this is del F del Y, where F is capital. This implies this is equal to a del F del Y is equal to I FZ. This implies FZ equal to 1 by I del F del Y, and 1 by I will be minus I. So FZ is equal to minus I del F del Y. Suppose number 4, from 3 and 4 we have del F del X is equal to minus I del F del Y. Suppose number 5, let capital FZ equal to UXY plus I times VXY. So del F del X will be equal to UX plus I times VX, that is, these are the partial derivatives of U and V with respect to X. Similarly, del F del Y will be equal to UY plus I times VY. Number 6, number 7, by Cauchy-Riemann equations, UX equal to VY and UY equal to minus VX. Then 7 implies, what will happen to minus I del F del Y? We are multiplying it with minus Y. So minus I del F del Y will be equal to minus I UY plus VY, it will be minus I square, that will be plus VY, so it is minus UY plus VY, that is equal to minus I and UY is equal to minus Vx from it by Cauchy-Riemann equations. It minus I times minus Vx plus Vy, this is Ux again by Cauchy-Riemann equations. So finally it is minus I times minus Vx plus Ux, that is equal to Ux plus I times Vx, that is equal to del F del X by 6. Ux plus I Vx is del F del X. That is del F del X is equal to minus I del F del Y. This gives the Cauchy-Riemann equations in terms of the function capital F. By assumption, a small FZ is continuous, otherwise this integral integral over L FZ dz would not be define. Hence, capital FZ is analytic. This capital FZ is analytic. Therefore, the condition of exactness is that there must exist a function capital FZ which is analytic. That is condition of exactness of this differential is that there exists a function capital FZ which is an analytic function. Remark number 3. From the remarks 1 and 2, we conclude that integral over L FZ DZ with F continuous depends only on the endpoints of L if and only if F is the derivative of an analytic function capital FZ in D. For example, we consider the function capital FZ equal to z minus a to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1, where n is greater than or equal to 0, which is an analytic function in the whole complex plane. What will happen to f dash z? Its derivative f dash z, this will be equal to z minus a to the power n. It is n plus 1 z minus a to the power n plus 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. So finally, we will be left with z minus a to the power n. If gamma is any closed curve, then it follows from theorem 3, lecture S26.1 and remark 3 that integral over gamma z minus a power n dz is equal to 0. This theorem states that if gamma is a closed curve and this is an analytic function, then integral over gamma of this function will be 0. This is a reference of the previous result. This is theorem number 3, lecture S26.1. So by this theorem, integral of this function, integral over gamma z minus e to power n dz will be equal to 0. Suppose number 9. If n is negative and n is not equal to minus 1, if this n is negative and n is not equal to minus 1, then also integral over gamma z minus a to power n dz is equal to 0 for all closed curves gamma which do not pass through a. What will happen if n is equal to minus 1? If n is minus 1, this will become integral over gamma dz by z minus a. And we have already proved in example number 1, lecture S25.9, this integral is equal to 2 pi I, where gamma is the circle mod z minus a equal to r. So these three remarks are very important, which find application in further results. Okay, thank you.